clean scent. When you're finished, toss it.
You know what's going on in your house? Major.
Expect a chance of rain on Thursday and Friday. And on Saturday, expect fair skies.
Welcome to the Tropical Update. We'll take you here in the Atlantic Basin and then talk about a tropical storm in the Eastern Pacific in just a moment. But of course, we're watching Hurricane Isabel very closely. Hurricane hunters have been out there this evening into this morning giving us the newest information. Winds are 115 miles per hour. That has come down a little bit. It's still, though, a Category 3 hurricane. While it's moving northwest at 7 miles per hour, pressure has come up to about 956 millibars, and that's good news. The fact that it has decreased in winds and increased in pressure. It is forecast, though, to maintain this intensity as it heads towards land, though, over the next day or two. So could make landfall. It's a Category 3. Pressure, again, 956 millibars. I just want to show you quickly the rest of the Atlantic is somewhat quiet. Let's talk about this more specifically, where we're looking at the western side of this storm. This hurricane has gotten hit by some shear, some westerly winds here. Actually brought in some drier air, too, so the combination of the two weakening our system, and again, that's good news. There is a slight chance that it could intensify some, though, as the shear may decrease a little bit as it heads closer to land, so we'll keep a close eye on that. But landfall possibly sometime Thursday. The Carolinas, Delmarva Peninsula, New Jersey, everybody here should be watching this very closely. For sure, we are going to see some big surf. Heavy surf advisories have been issued up and down the coast here in the southeast. And, of course, some folks have been asked to evacuate North Carolina. State of emergency in Virginia declared here as Hurricane Isabel approaches. And, again, we'll give you more details as we get more information from the hurricane hunters. Otherwise, the Atlantic Basin quiet, nice in the Gulf and the Caribbean. Eastern Pacific, we do have a tropical storm. Once a hurricane, now downgraded to a tropical storm, Linda, winds at 65 miles per hour. It should move more towards the southwest in time. Nick?
Joining us now is Marshall Cease of your weather today. And Marshall, how will you track Hurricane Isabel's progress and the efforts to get ready for the storm?
Well, Nick, Jim Cantore will join us live from Nags Head, North Carolina. He'll have the latest on preparations there. Then Dr. John Neese looks at the places that could face the greatest threats of high wind and waves and torrential rain, possible flooding from Isabel. Back to you, Nick.
Well, though still in the Atlantic, Hurricane Isabel is having a major effect on big business in the United States. Linda Bell has details in the Bloomberg Money Barometer.
Good morning. Hurricane Isabel was the theme on Wall Street yesterday. Consumers bought supplies at Home Depot, the world's largest home improvement retailer, amid the hurricane's approach to the East Coast. Robert Morris, the manager at a Home Depot in Virginia Beach, said it's hard to keep up with what consumers are asking for. Now onto the potential cost of the hurricane. According to Lehman Brothers, Allstate has the greatest risk in the Carolinas and Virginia with a 12.3% market share. The firm says hitting the Carolinas would cause less damage than if Isabel veered north to toward more densely populated areas like New Jersey or New York. According to Risk Management Solutions, insured damages may range from $4 to $24 billion, with New York's Long Island being the costliest potential landfall. If damage from Isabel is similar to Hurricane Hugo, a storm of a similar magnitude, which cost East Coast insurers more than $4 billion in 1989, the company says that Allstate may face $500 million in losses. For the Weather Channel, I'm Linda Bell with the Bloomberg Money Barometer.
Will we see an impact of Hurricane Isabel this weekend? Well, we think at this point it will be long gone, just a memory here, maybe a few showers here in parts of New York State. Otherwise, a gorgeous weekend setting up for Chicago, at least for Saturday, here for Mayor Daley's Kids and Kites Festival. Enjoy some great weather. We do have the rain moving, it looks like, on Sunday. The East Coast, though, looking delightful.
How delightful or not are your travels today? Let's check in with our travel analyst.
Throughout the Northeast looks great, Nick, as we can anticipate lots of sunshine. The rain will be moving out of Boston, New York clearing on out, Philadelphia looking good, and Washington, D.C. some good travel. Good day to prepare for what may be coming later in the week.
That's it for First Outlook, everyone. Have a great day.
Thanks for joining us on this Tuesday morning. Stay tuned. Your weather today follows local updates.
I'd love to buy you dinner.
Nice try. I know about the free rebate.
Okay.
The Swanson Dinner Rebate lets you try delicious fried chicken, mashed potatoes, and sweet corn for free.
So eight-ish.
No-ish.
Hi, how you doing?
I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Look at Hurricane Isabel. Want to start with mandatory evacuations. North Carolina over at Ocracoke, as well as Dare County, and now the Currituck Outer Banks under mandatory evacuations as you all complete any preparations before Isabel makes landfall. And again, we'll discuss the track of this hurricane coming up shortly. Currently, as of 11 a.m., 27.4 north, 71.2 west. That's about 605 miles off to the south-southeast of Cape Hatteras. Top sustained winds, 105 miles per hour, so that definitely has been going down. It is now a Category 2 on the Saffir-Simpson scale. There's the pressure estimated. There should be another reconnaissance aircraft. Haven't seen any new reports as of this time, but hopefully we'll get some sometime over the next few hours. Again, here's our hurricane off to the southeast of North Carolina at the present time. Hurricane watches up from Little River Inlet northward all the way up to North Beach, Maryland. That's the Chesapeake. Tidal Potomac up to D.C. also under a hurricane watch on the Atlantic side, Chincoteague, Virginia, as well as Albemarle, Pamlico Sounds also under hurricane watches. Tropical storm watches out from Little River Inlet southward to South Santee River. It's possible that later this evening sometime that tropical storm watches may be extended north of the hurricane watches depending on the exact track with this hurricane. Here it is. This is a Hurricane Isabel. Just watch the structure here. It was very well defined when it was a Category 5, Category 4 hurricane. Then all of a sudden it starts hitting that wind shear and dry air on the western flank of this storm, the western and southwestern side, and that's what did the number on it. That's what caused it to weaken considerably, some of these westerly winds coming in from the southeastern United States. Here's another vantage point. Looking at the colors here, these deeper purple colors in the red, those are what we call the coldest cloud tops. And what does that mean? Those are the ones that are highest in the atmosphere, and those are usually associated with the heaviest rain, the strongest wind. So that's what we study closely, watching for this central core of the hurricane, that eye wall, which really has broken down quite a bit because of some of these winds from the west. Visible satellite imagery showing the hurricane here, and right over the center of circulation you can see some of those coldest cloud tops that appear to be building up a little bit more again. The key to watching this storm here will be the western side, the western flank. This is a water vapor image here. Reason this is important is because it allows us to study some of the drier air. This orange color here, that's an area of dry air, and that's what the hurricane ran into the past couple days. And the dry air plus some of these westerly winds, I think you can see those blowing toward the hurricane. That's what got ingested by the hurricane and caused it to weaken. Now, as we look at a bigger picture here, we've been watching the hurricane. Some of these westerly winds have chewed it apart some, and notice a large area of dry air back in the Carolinas. But if you look at the last couple of pictures here, it's making steady progress as dry air, then it gets hung up right on the coast here. So what we are thinking at this time is that this ridge of high pressure may try to rebuild. So it's still possible. Yes, we have 105 mile per hour winds now. It's possible that there could be some strengthening before it makes landfall, so just stay prepared. That's the bottom line here. Forecast does call for the system to come up toward North Carolina, eventually over towards central Virginia, west of D.C. and Baltimore, with some gusty winds and heavy rain. Looking at eastern North Carolina, I wanted to point this out here. Notice a lot of the land is very low, so not only will the Outer Banks experience a surge, but anytime you get the wind blowing over the sound, you have to watch it all the way back up to Washington. There's been some floods recently, several years ago, Fran and Bertha. Could be looking at that again, some of these tidal surges from the Pamlico Sound being shifted right back up into the river area. So don't discount that either, back over towards some of these inland rivers. Rest of the tropical Atlantic actually looking pretty good. Caribbean Sea, Gulf of Mexico looking fine. We still have hurricane or tropical storm Linda in the Pacific. Of course, we'll keep you updated on Isabel and a complete look at your forecast after your update on the 8th.
I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Vanilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere.
The road is full of choices. Stay twice at these choice hotels this fall and earn a free night with choice privileges. Earn an unlimited number of free nights. For reservations or more details, visit choice.
expect a chance of rain on Thursday and Friday. And on Saturday, expect fair skies.
Hurricane Isabel now working closer and closer to the east coast of the U.S. The wind's now 105 miles an hour. That is a Category 2 storm. It is moving toward the north-northwest at about 8 miles an hour. And we'll have more on that forecast track coming up in just a moment. Welcome back. It's 10 minutes before the hour and time for the tropical update. I'm Carl Parker.
And I'm Christina Abernathy. Let's check in with our hurricane expert, Dr. Steve Lyons. And Steve, we know a lot more about where Isabel might hit, but we don't know everything yet.
That's correct, Christina. There's still some uncertainty in exactly where it's going, but we're narrowing it in to basically two areas. Let's look at the latest projected path. The two areas basically are the southeastern portion of North Carolina or right into the Virginia, Washington area up the Chesapeake Bay. That's a possibility as well. Most likely track basically is the outskirts of the Outer Banks of North Carolina, and the time frame is sometime midday on Thursday. Now let's look at a couple of features here. First of all, we start homing in on this single dot. That can be a mistake because the area of tropical storm winds marked in yellow and the area of hurricane force winds marked in orange here are much greater than a point. And so a large area is going to be impacted by the hurricane as it moves to the north, not just a single point. So we want to make sure that areas well to the east and north of the center and a little bit to the southeast of the center realize that you can get impacted even though the center doesn't hit right next to you. Now let's look at something else as well. We're looking at the hurricane, and as we're looking through time, it's starting to become a little better organized again. The upper level wind shear over here that we saw these westerlies, there's a little ridge of high pressure in there, and that's causing that ridge to have a little less shear on the system, and it's trying to come right back, and so the pressure's falling. Latest hurricane reconnaissance. So there's that little ridge of high pressure right in there. You see it in the high clouds there moving clockwise right into the system. That's weaker wind, but there's faster wind over here, and that wind may continue to come on through and may affect it in a negative fashion later. The trick is, how fast is this fast wind here of about 40 miles per hour going to come over as this system moves to the north? Still a question about the uncertainty and the intensity, but nevertheless, we can say one thing for sure, that the impact, one impact we can say for sure anyway, is that beach erosion is going to be significant and fairly high along the North Carolina coastline. That's a positive for sure. The remainder of the Atlantic is relatively quiet tonight, so if you're heading out there on any cruise or a destination in the Caribbean, great weather there. And in the eastern Pacific, our tropical storm Linda, which was briefly a hurricane, now a low-level vortex, rapidly losing thunderstorms, and only a few lingering swells along the coast of Baja to worry about there. Christina?
And Steve, what are the potential impacts farther inland, say around Washington, D.C.?
Well, if it heads a little bit farther east and goes right up the Chesapeake Bay area, we could see significant surge there and much stronger winds along that area. Right now, we're not too sure that that's going to be the track. If it landfalls farther to the southeast, then most of the impact will be on the coastline farther to the east, away from Washington, D.C., Carl.
Dr. Steve Lyons, thank you so much, and we'll talk to you again at the top of the hour. Let's quickly show you what's happening in the way of watches right now. We have hurricane watches in effect from the southern part of the Chesapeake Bay and across the Delmarva into Chincoteague, Virginia, down to Little River Inlet, South Carolina. Tropical storm warnings, or watches rather, are up from Little Egg Inlet, New Jersey, down to Chincoteague, the northern part of the bay, and also from Little River Inlet, South Carolina, down to the South Santee River.
Well, there's much more to come on the second hour of Weather Center. We'll continue to track Isabel and bring you the very latest on this dangerous and potentially destructive hurricane.
Stay with us. We'll be right back after your local on the 8s.
What brings you to the Rhode Island Culinary Institute?
That's a good question.
What brings you to Southern New Mexico State?
You travel many miles. Weigestalt School of Art.
What made you decide to make the trip all the way to Memphis Polytech?
159 a week for any mid-size at budget. For irresistible prices on irresistible cars, call 1-800-BUDGET-7 or visit budget.com.
Log on to budget.com.